Global reinsurance market came under the spotlight at AM Best's Europe Insurance Market Briefing, held recently in London. I'm Richard Banks with AM Best TV. I'm joined now by Mathilde Jakobsen, Director Analytics at AM Best, one of the speakers at the Europe Insurance Market Briefing. Mathilde, thanks for being with us. You delivered a very insightful presentation analysing the state of the global reinsurance market. Can you tell us a little bit about how that market shaped up in 2020?
Yeah, well, one of the things we saw was actually an increase in the amount of capital that's dedicated to the global reinsurance market. And it wasn't necessarily what we had expected. Certainly during the year, we saw a lot of volatility in investment markets, which does have an impact on the level of capital. But, you know, compared to the market volatility we saw in March 2020, By the end of the year, the capital markets had largely recovered, and so we didn't see that impact on capital we perhaps had expected. So actually, the capital levels increased compared to 19. So we estimate dedicated reinsurance capital at $517 billion in 2020, which is up from $482 billion in 19. And it really reflects this recovery in the investment markets during the year. And then it was also supported by the suspension of dividends that a lot of players had during the year, right? So no dividends were paid from a lot of them. And there was also suspension of share buybacks. And in addition to that, we also saw new capital enter the market.
Excellent. We'll talk about new capital in just a second. But traditionally, there's been a lot of talk about the split between dedicated reinsurance capital and third-party capital. Can you tell us a little bit about how that situation is developing?
Yeah, so the increase in dedicated capital we saw in 2020 was all on the traditional side, which is interesting. So the third-party capital remained flat between 19 and 20. We split third-party capital into three buckets, right? So you have direct institutional investors, reinsurance-sponsored managers, such as Skycars, and then dedicated ILS managers. And what we've seen pretty much since 2018 is a much closer alignment between third-party and traditional capital. So a lot of this dedicated third-party capital now is really either reinsurance sponsored or it's written by dedicated ILS managers that work in very close alignment with traditional capital. So as I said before, we saw it flat in between 19 and 20, but we would expect an increase in 21. So we are seeing more interest in both cat bonds and collateralized reinsurance. So We might see a tick up in 2021 after really quite flat numbers for 2 years.
So you mentioned new entrants a little bit earlier on. Can you tell us a little bit about what we're seeing there and how you think that might play out?
Yeah, so we saw a number of new entrances to the market attracted by the hardening conditions and the better pricing we've seen. And it's really the better pricing than a long period of time. So we estimate that there's been an injection of new capital to the market of around $20 billion in 2020, but only about half of that have been dedicated to reinsurance, with the rest supporting specialty and commercial insurance. And that's really quite modest, right, when you think about this overall size of $517 billion. Perhaps surprising, I don't know, but what is clear is that it takes time to set up new entities, right? You have to get them licensed, you have to get infrastructures there, you have to recruit for them. So we continue to see new entrances attracted to this market. But it does take a while to set up and get licensed and rated and have the people in place to be able to start writing business.
Taking into account all these factors that you've talked about, how does that contribute to the outlook for the global reinsurance market?
Yeah, so we have a stable outlook on the global reinsurance market, and I could talk about the outlook, you know, for a lot, but just focusing on capital. So the the reinsurance market remains very well capitalized, which is a positive factor in this stable outlook. We talked about how the hardening of the markets has attracted new entrances to the markets, but we're not seeing that have a detrimental effect on the pricing of it, right? So you know, the new entrances are typically run by seasoned management team. They're there to take advantage of the higher prices. So we haven't seen them have a softening effect on the market. So we would expect firming pricing conditions to continue, at least for this year into the next, supporting the stable outlook together with this very well capitalized market.
Fascinating stuff. Thank you very much indeed, Mathilde, for joining us today.
My pleasure. Thank you.
For more details about AM Best's Europe Insurance Market Briefing and a host of related insight, visit ambest.com. For AM Best TV, I'm Richard Banks.